Yeah, well, that's not a bad beat.
Quads?
The one outer on the river is not a bad beat?
No, that's not a bad
Top's
beat.
Tops that? Oh.
What's a bad beat to you?
What's a bad beat?
Wake me up if I'm falling head first.
Hello world. Today is day two of the Millionaire Maker. Alright, so button in seat 9, which means we're going to be big blind first. We're going to be playing tight early. We're just going to be saving our chips, trying to look for the most optimal spot to double them. And then we'll be able to play our normal game from there. I looked at my table draw. I didn't recognize anyone except for one person. We have a crusher, Andrew Moreno, probably known from winning the Win Millions and a lot of other tournaments like that. Very hot player right now. Late night last night, we watched Lou win his first bracelet ever. He's from our home game back home. Congratulations, Lou. You're one of the best PLO players I know, so no surprise that you won that one. And congratulations to you and Carla on getting engaged. Yeah, let's try to follow those footsteps and win this bracelet. He went over a million yesterday. Let's win over a million in this one. So we're coming in with 64,000. We'll catch you on the first break.
You can't start speaking when he's open the pot when there's still other people in the hand. It's really bad.
Are you in hand?
Yeah,
just me and him.
I was in the hand. Yeah, I got double cards. You can't start speaking.
No, you're in the hand. You're full already.
You can't do it.
He talked to me. I talked to him.
No, you just come and keep the action was here when you started speaking. When it's on you, fine. You can't do it when it's like 6 feet back. It's really bad.
Whatever, bro. I'm not talking to you. I'm just between me and him.
I'm just telling you. If you do it again, I'll just call the floor.
You can't call the floor. Just me and him talking. He didn't call the floor. You call the floor. Go ahead.
Started with 64,000 and we're at 51,000. Coming back to 4K big blind, we're about 100 away from the money, maybe a little bit less than that. It's roller coaster level. So like we were as low as 40K and as high as 107K, but ended with 51K. Probably saved my tournament life by playing ace king real slow. There was just a bunch of action behind after I had just called the original raise. There was like a three bet and a cold call from in position players, so I just decided to only call and just go to the flop. That saved our tournament luck because they had kings and queens over there. Yeah, I was able to just fold the flop and just lose the original open and then three bet. So yeah, coming back to 4K big blind, we need a double. Hopefully we can just pick something up right off the bat and just double right away. I'll be grinding out looking for that optimal spot to double. If we have to get it all in before the bubble, it is what it is. We just got to do it. We'll catch you on the next break. I want to remind you, this is our last tournament of this trip, but we will be back July 3rd and playing the main event starting like July 4th, July 5th. Yeah, we're going to go home, reset, and prepare for the main event. We'll be back in early July.
He went out on break. He said he smoked so much weed he can't remember where he's supposed to be. So if anybody knows who this guy is right here, he's supposed to be on your table. He says he has a stack of about 450K. Help him out. He's trying to find his seat. Oh, we found him. We found him. All right. Congratulations.
I'm glad you found your seat.
Thank you.
Did you really not know where it was?
I just wanted to, like, you know, make myself look like a big idiot in front of...
How many people?
Just 1,600.
Yeah. Thank you.
Good luck.
2,000 small blind, 4,000 big blind ATF, 4,000. Dealers, please shovel up and deal.
Okay, so we're 10 away from the money, so we're 9 away from the direct bubble. Great neighbor right here. A Texas man.
Yes, sir. Houston.
Houston, Texas. On the bubble from plus two.
1,416 players. Right now we have 10,560 more. Guess what that means? You're all in the money!
Okay, so the bubble has burst. We are now in the money. We have 49,000 at 4K big blind, so just 12 big blinds. It's time to get it in and double up. All right, so we're in the Millionaire Maker and we're in the money. And guess who's here with us in the money? It's Bob. It's hashtag more Bob.
Usually my wife is the one who does this on a video.
Well, you can go ahead and say maybe I'm his wife.
She's a little prettier. Not that I judge, and I could, you know, it's 2023. I mean, if I was, you know,
true,
you'd be in my top 70.
Hey, I'm, 80, I feel great about that.
100.
I feel really great about that.
85.
Bob, how are you doing in the tourney?
Got 250K.
Awesome.
With 5K big blinds. That's
awesome. That's beautiful. I think Bob's going to final table and win this one. I've got like 8 big blinds right now. Bob, I need to spin it up.
Let's get it up. Good luck.
Thank you so much. You too. I folded everything. I'm just looking for anything to go with it this one.
Don't know if I stay. I don't know where I'll go, where I'll be today. How to get comfortable, cause I can't stay in place. They don't know what I know, so I stay somewhere. I don't know, babe, where I'm going. Peace out, this damn GPS don't know where to go.
Just busted the Millionaire Maker. I just couldn't get anything going. I got into the money. That was nice. And then just went card dead. Bad card distribution there when it mattered the most. Couldn't pick anything up. Blinded down pretty low, as you saw. And then ended up getting it all in with eights versus the big blind. He had King Jack. Turned us dead, turned us straight. So let's go around the World Series of Poker and see what else is going on.
Yeah,
we got Jay back.
Jay Becker. I was the guy that won all those win tournaments. Those daily tournaments. That's me. Yeah.
Really? Is that really you?
Yeah, that's him.
Oh, hey, what's up? Me. Okay, yeah. So Jeremy Becker.
Yep.
Okay, Jeremy Becker. They didn't draft like Negreanu to say he wanted to draft you a bunch of times.
I was told I was getting drafted, but yeah. He didn't draft me. I'm his bonus player in the other one.
In all the other ones, yeah, I saw that. He is the bonus player. Yep. What's the deepest run this summer in the World Series events only?
5K freeze out. Okay. I got 50-something.
Hey, good run. That's a tough field.
Yeah, but
you usually play that field? Or are we hot right now and we're playing everything?
No, I'd be playing it.
You'd be playing it anyways?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, very impressive with all those wins this year.
I wasted them. Too early.
No, it's never a waste. You know, that it's just, it's a sign of more good things to come, you know? That's all it can be.
Yes, sir.
And you must be doing something right. Continue to do that. And, you know, you're going to win one of them big ones, too.
Let's hope so, yeah.
So give me the worst bad beat that you had this World Series.
I've lost with two aces, all in pre-flop, 4 times so far this series. 0-4.
No, but a bad beat. None of
all in pre.
Which ones?
Like what tournaments?
No. Which ones were
me?
All in pre?
I'm saying them. 4 all times I've gotten it in pre with aces, 0-4.
What did they have on them?
Ace-Jack. I lost.
Okay, that one's kind of stand. Oh, King, that one, okay, so not a bad beat.
Well, they all hurt, you know, you got two aces, the money's in pretty.
Ace-Jack,
you know?
I'll give you like a little bit of a bad beat, but what's the other two?
Ace-Jack, I lost the nines, and I lost the ace-King.
So
the next time I'm winning with the two aces, that's my prediction. I'm winning next time I get it in.
All right, that's fair, but will you give me a bad beat story?
I don't like doing bad beat stories, but I took one not in the World Series.
Okay,
I took one
here
a little
go.
Bit before the World Series. Good. Got in aces again. First kings.
Okay.
We both flopped sets. It came ace king 3 and he rivered another king. That one hurt. Is not, that not what you're looking for?
Not
what?
A bad beat.
What do you mean bad beat then?
Like,
that's as bad as it gets. It's
like you get it in with sixes. Let me think. Oh yeah, the one the guy told me earlier. He got in with sevens. two people called him that both had ace king.
That's a bad beat.
I'm Branson.
I'm Biddy.
All right, nice to meet you, boys. How many years have you been to the WSOP?
I think this will be my like fourth year, third year.
This is my second year.
Okay, all right. And do either of you plan on playing the main event this year?
Not me.
I'm firing the main event irresponsibly. I'm just sending it.
Okay, just sending it. Way to go. All right, I like that.
Putting like half my net worth on the line.
Tell me what's the worst bad beat. I want to hear the worst bad beat from either of you that you've taken.
Oh, I'll go. I was just getting into poker. I'm 22 years old. I probably have like 5K to my name less. I go to a home game for the first time ever. I buy in for a grand. I run it up to like 3K. First time I'm ever at this home game. Flop top set, king six deuce, get it all in on the flop against pocket sixes, boom, six on the river, he makes quads, and I swear, I was pretty high, I could have sworn the game was rigged, I thought that it was a setup, but it was like a, maybe a 3% chance that it was actually a setup, but like, I was overthinking, and I'm like, no way, but I'll never know, and that was brutal.
Yeah, well, that's not a bad beat.
Quads?
The one outer on the river is not a bad beat?
No, that's not a bad
top
beat.
Top set? Oh.
What's a bad beat to you?
What's a bad beat?
Well, one guy earlier was saying he got in with sevens against ace, king, and ace, king. He lost that spot. He lost to two of them. He got bad beated by both of them. They both hit ace on him.
So that's slightly less bad. Probably a lot less bad.
Yeah, that's like common.
So four outer.
That's a bad beat.
That's a four outer versus a one outer.
But the other one's a really bad beat, right?
Because kings versus sixes on a king six.
For a triple up?
In what? What's the context? Is it main event?
It was like level two of, I think it was the...
I mean...
It wasn't the main event, but it was...
I thought you were joking.
It was the 800 deep stack.
Are you serious?
Yeah, of course.
All right.
No, I mean...
We'll let you guys decide.
Wait, no, because like, I think you really think that's a bad beat. The kings against the sixes.
What?
Usually, a good poker player, he will be good on other stuff, because we're talking about a brain game and a competitive game. So usually, I'm just saying usually, poker players that are very good at poker, they are many times good at other stuff because they just have a good decision-making process. And not only in sports, but in life, in like every day eating healthy or not, going to the gym every day or not, like working out or not, having a healthy lifestyle or not. So I believe poker, for anyone who's thinking about playing poker, is a good choice because no matter what happens, you will learn something with it. Even if you know how to deal with frustrations, know how to deal with successes, there are people that don't know either how to deal with frustrations, and when they win, they brag about it, and they don't understand that poker, sooner or later, poker is going to give you a punch in the stomach, just like it gave it to all of us, and it's going to happen, you know, and you got to know how to deal with it.
Must maintain your mindset, you know? It takes a little physical relaxation to maintain the mental relaxation.
Tell them to like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe, babies.
If you use my eyes and say too much, I'm deaf. I'm 100% deaf.
Are you deaf?
I can't hear at all. I read lips.
Good to meet you, Randy.
Huh?
Nice to meet you, Randy.
Yeah, nice to meet you too, man.
Thank you.
Don't work too hard.
You too. Get home safe.
This is a troll.
He's yanking our chain.
Yeah, he's trolling.
Our chain's getting yanked.
This is for sure a troll.
Yes,
you
a troll.
Tell us who your worst bad beat.
Yeah, it's a troll.
We tell everyone, that's our bit. We tell everyone their bad beat story is not a bad beat.
Yeah.
And then like, they ask us, well, what the hell is a bad beat? And we tell them some dumbass hand like that.
So that's going to wrap up this trip. Really appreciate everyone who's out there watching. We hope that you enjoyed the episodes. We really enjoyed making them. We're going to go home for a week. We're going to come back for the main event.
We have some stuff in the vault that we think might be good, and if it is, we're going to release this, some special episodes, some deleted scenes episodes, stuff like that. We'll see y'all in July for the main event.
That was a fun trip.
Like and subscribe. Hey, 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 I be in the light.